You're standing still, or at least that's what it feels like. But right now, as you casually exist, you're actually moving at 1,670 kilometers per hour, 1,037 miles per hour, if you're near the equator. That's the speed at which Earth spins. Now imagine this. You start running. Not at your usual pace, not even at Usain Bolt's speed of 44.72 kilometers per hour, 27.8 miles per hour. No, this time you're pushing beyond human limits. You're running faster than the planet itself. What happens next? Well, congratulations. You just became a human time traveler. Are you moving forward in time or backward? To understand what's going on, we need to talk about reference frames. When you're on a plane flying at 900 kilometers per hour, 560 miles per hour, you don't feel like you're moving because everything around you, your seat, the tray table, your bag of overpriced airport snacks, is moving with you. Earth works the same way. You don't feel its spin because everything, air, oceans, buildings, you, is moving along with it. But if you outrun that spin, you're now moving relative to Earth's rotation. If you run eastward, you're moving even faster than Earth's spin, meaning time passes slightly slower for you. That's right. You're technically experiencing time dilation, the same effect astronauts feel on the International Space Station, where they move at 28,000 kilometers per hour, 17,500 miles per hour, and gain an extra 0.07 seconds every 6 months. But if you run westward, against Earth's rotation, things get weird. You're now running toward the past, at least from an observational standpoint. If you were fast enough, you'd see the sun rise in reverse, birds would flap backward, planes flying east would appear frozen in place. But can you actually go back in time? Well, no. Einstein won't let you break physics that easily. But to an observer standing still, it would look like you were reversing the flow of time. Breaking the sound barrier on foot. Of course, running at Earth's rotational speed isn't just about clocks moving weirdly. It's also about physics completely betraying your body. At 1,670 kilometers per hour, 1,037 miles per hour, you're running faster than the speed of sound, 1,235 kilometers per hour, or 767 miles per hour. This means you'd create a sonic boom. That's right, every footstep would generate a mini explosion of compressed air. Here's the problem. Sonic booms are brutal. Fighter jets that break the sound barrier generate shockwaves so powerful they can shatter windows from kilometers away. Now imagine that force coming from your feet. Every step you take sends out violent ripples through the atmosphere, possibly knocking over trees, shattering nearby structures, and deafening anyone within a mile radius. Oh, and let's not forget air resistance. At those speeds, the force of air hitting your body would be over 10,000 newtons per square meter. That's like being hit by a brick wall of wind every second. The heat from friction alone would likely set your clothes on fire within moments. So, in short, you wouldn't get far. What about gravity? Let's pretend, for a moment, that your body is somehow built for this, that your legs are unbreakable, that you don't turn into a human torch. Would you still be on the ground? Not necessarily. See, the faster you move, the more centrifugal force comes into play. Earth's rotation already creates a slight outward push. This is why objects weigh less at the equator than at the poles. If you run faster than Earth's spin, you're increasing that outward force. At extreme speeds, gravity might not be able to keep up. You'd start feeling lighter, your strides would take you higher, and at some point, if you somehow reached 28,440 kilometers per hour, 17,700 miles per hour, you just keep going. That's orbital velocity. At that speed, you're no longer running, you're falling around the Earth. Congratulations, you're now an accidental astronaut. What did we learn? So, what happens if you run faster than the rotation of the Earth? 1. If you run eastward, time slows down for you. 2. If you run westward, it looks like you're moving backward in time. 3. At supersonic speeds, every footstep would create a sonic boom. 4. Air resistance would burn you alive. 5. If you go fast enough, you might escape Earth's gravity altogether. In short, don't try it. But hey, if you ever gain superpowers and decide to test this out, make sure to wear flameproof shoes. If you enjoyed this wild thought experiment, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss the next deep dive into absurd science. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.